and our role editor, Chris Schick, joins me now. First reaction, Chris?
Mary, we have been talking this afternoon about the significant statement from Buckingham Palace at lunchtime today. I think this was the news that everyone dreaded, but the news that came just in the last few moments, a very short statement that she died peacefully at Balmoral this afternoon. We now have a king and a queen consort who will remain at Balmoral. We are talking, Mary, about an extraordinary life, and this is a very somber moment for the nation. We are reflecting on someone who was head of state for 70 years, for seven decades, and at this moment, we are all witnesses to history. Most people who live in this country can remember no other head of state, no other monarch, other than Queen Elizabeth II. As we have been discussing, she was working until the very end. Only 2 days ago, there at Balmoral Castle, in the drawing room, the pictures of the Queen meeting her 15th Prime Minister. This is a live shot of Buckingham Palace where the Union flag has been lowered to half-mast. Now, at every royal residence, the flag will be lowered to half-mast, apart from at Balmoral, where the King's standard will still be flown at the top of the mast. It's difficult. There we have Downing Street again, the flags at half mast. Now, flags will stay in this position for the next 10 or 11 days and will only be raised again the day after the Queen's funeral. Mourning will take place for that period of time. Royal mourning, however, Mary, will continue for about a month. We were seeing pictures just 2 days ago, the Queen working until the very end, the Queen meeting her 15th Prime Minister, Liz Truss, from whom we will expect a statement in the next few moments. And a year when the country was celebrating the 70-year reign of the Queen, the Platinum Jubilee, when tens of thousands of people turned out to show their appreciation over the long Jubilee weekend. But we now have a king. We are presuming he will reign as King Charles, but we will wait for an announcement from Buckingham Palace. And the king at the moment remains at Balmoral.
Chris, it is a moment in history, isn't it? Yeah.